Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Pittsburgh Pirates franchise series here in MLB 13, the show. The Pirates are about to host the LA Dodgers here at PNC, and it's about time to get underway as the teams get ready to take the field. And on the mound today, we will have Wandy Rodriguez. He's been up and down and had his struggles. He gives up a base hit right here in the first inning, so right off the bat, not how he wants to start. Worried about Carl Crawford at first base, so much so that he airmails this one out of play and lets him go to second base with the throwing error on the pickoff. Now you've got a single to right field. Aaron Hicks is coming up throwing, and how does he get Carl Crawford at the plate? I do not know, but he does. Nicks him ever so closely there, and the game is still tied. This one's going to be hit at Jim Thome, who steps on first base, and an escape artist is Wandy Rodriguez in this game in the first inning. And we go to the bottom of the first. We've got a double right out of the gates here for Starlin Castro. He's going to be standing on second with a Pirates threat in the bottom of the first. Now we get to see how Zach Greinke responds. He responds by getting Thome to ground out to first base. Now that was hit really hard, but a nice play. Keeps them off the board as well. Now the Dodgers race out to a 5-0 lead, trying to come back in the ballgame for the Pirates. John McDonald will reach the seats here and at least break Greinke's shutout with a solo homer to left. So they're on the board. They get to shoot off the fireworks for once today, so that's a good thing. You see the replay, hits at 380 feet. Not a blast by any means, but it does clear the fence, and it counts for a solo homer. So they're on the board, and hopefully maybe sparking a comeback later in the same inning. Aaron Hicks will hit one deep to right field, and this one's not coming back. Two homers in the same inning. Too bad they're solo homers, but it puts the Pirates that much closer at 5-2. Goodbye baseball indeed. We'll go to the replay and see Aaron Hicks swing. That pulls this one to right field. He knew this was gone when he hit it. A little bit more of a no-doubter than McDonald's blast to left, but it will count just the same. So 5-2 into the sixth inning. Wandy Rodriguez is long gone here. We've actually gone to the bullpen trying to solidify things, and things are calming down now that we're trying to get back into this. Nice job there by Contos holding things down out of the bullpen. So it's 5-2 going to the bottom of the sixth. We are in the bottom of the sixth now when Willingham is going to get that past the third baseman and out into left for a single. So we got a runner on. Jim Thome at the plate looking for a good result here. Hits this to straightaway center field. Tracking back is Kemp, but he runs out of room. It's a two-run homer, and the Pirates have cut the lead to 5-4. Down just one now as Jim Thome lumberjacks one out of here to center field, and the Pirates fans are certainly back in this ballgame now. You see Thome on the replay. Goes down and gets this. That's one of his definite power spots. He likes the ball down and away, and he gets it and takes it out over the center field fence. And it's new life for the Pirates. But a 3-2 count with one out for the Dodgers, and this ball is fair down the right field line. Hicks trying to get down there and play it. Meanwhile, runners coming around to score a second one to the plate, and the Dodgers open this up a little bit at 7-4. That's a big response right there from LA. They actually end up running away with it in the late innings, and it's an 11-4 victory for the Dodgers. Pirates put some pressure on for a little while there, but it was not enough. Things kind of fall apart, and they take the loss. So the Dodgers win this one going away 11-4. You see four ninth inning runs kind of spoiled any comeback hopes, and Greinke gets his victory. So next up, we've got a trade offer coming in. The Astros want a deal. What do they got for us? I don't think the Astros have much to deal at all, do they? Philip Humber for Starlin Marte. Let me think. A B potential 80 overall pitcher who's 30 years old, or my 24-year-old A potential outfielder? Let's see. No, I don't want to make that deal. Let's pass that and leave it behind us. We've got some winning going on here. Winning ways for the Pirates. We're now 40-34. Make that 41-34 as we get into the second game against the Angels. Pineda won again. in game one. They want me to sit Lincecum down in the order, consider starting someone else. I politely say, nah, I'm going to start him. I went out and got him for a reason. I'm going to pitch him here against the Angels' big bats. So you see, fortunes have turned around for the Pirates of late. We're climbing in the NL Central standings, and we've got interleague play here in a whopper of a pitching matchup between Lincecum and Weaver. You see, runner on first, that's Marte taking off, pitch out, and it's called perfectly because they get Castro at second base. Nice call by Mike Socha to pitch out, and it catches the Pirates and foils their plans right there to get a runner on second base. So Socha looking quite smart right there, calling that from the dugout. And later in the inning, McCutchen will strike out. So Weaver is through the first without any problems. Now it is Tim Lincecum's turn, and he will get a grounder from Trout. Nice play by Walker, spinning around to throw him out right there. Tougher than it seemed, really. He had to make a play. So 3-2 count with two outs. Josh Hamilton swinging over that changeup, and he will be a strikeout victim. So Lincecum has a nice first inning as well. We're on to the third and a 3-2 count. McDonald does a nice job of seeing quite a few pitches and finally fights one off into left field to get on base. He's now at second with Starlin Castro at the plate. This is grounded to third, and the low throw will not be scooped by Albert Pujols, and runners at the corners. So Pujols could not come up with a big play. And we've got McCutchen again. He's going to give this a ride. Center field. Are we talking three-run homer? No. Caught short of the warning track by Trout, and trouble averted once again by Jared Weaver. Here come the Angels in the third. 1-2 count, two outs. Dribbler in front of the plate. You find Lincecum dashing to get this, and a good strong throw will get him. Just barely. Lincecum makes a play, and they're out of the inning. He actually shattered his bat on this play. And as you can see, only two hits aside so far in this pitcher's duel. Into the fifth, still scoreless. Aaron Hicks going to ground this ball to second. No problem. Weaver once again out of an inning. Lincecum not to be outdone in the fifth. 2-2 count. And he's got the changeup past Howie Kendrick right there. Fooling him with the change of speeds. 1-2 count to Jimenez. Freezes him with the low fastball, 91 mile an hour. That's just not fair. Two outs. And this is going to be grounded to McDonald, who kind of bats at it, but does recover to throw him out. Tim Lincecum and Jared Weaver battling each other through five innings, only five hits total for this game. So we'll see how the Pirates bats respond in the sixth inning against Weaver. This is Castro again, giving it a good ride, but it's going to be taken care of in left field. No runner on at that point. McCutchen comes to the plate with one out. He hits the ball pretty well past the third baseman. Nice job of getting on for Andrew McCutchen, hoping to start the rally and get his team a run. Jim Thome finds a pitch he likes, slaps this to right field. McCutchen had to wait up there to not get hit by the ball, does get into second safely. So two runners on. Gabby Sanchez is going to fly this deep to right center field. It almost gets out of here. It's caught at the warning track by Trout. Both runners going to tag up. Now Thome just kind of followed along there. He's no speedster, but knowing this throw was going to go to third base. Actually, if they cut this thing off, they probably could have had him at second. But Trout goes for it here. And we've got runners at second and third, two outs. But Neil Walker pops it up behind the dish. And Weaver has escaped again. Still no score. Oh, that's a tough one to let go. We've got a ground ball by Trout to second. Neil Walker will throw him out. We've kept Trout off the board so far today. No damage against us. Hamilton, same thing, ties him up with a changeup inside, and he is set down once again. Doing well against these big bats of the Angels lineup. How about Pujols? Nah, grounder to second. Walker will take care of him. Both these pitchers living up to their billing as top dogs in the rotation. Look at this. Trumbo goes down on strike swinging. Who's going to blink first between these two? Lincecum. Here you see his pitch selection for his 76 pitches into this start so far. So 43% four-seam fastball. 2-2 count here to Howie Kendrick. Gets him to pop this up. Shortstop Starlin Castro calls for it and makes the catch. Again out of an inning. And they go to grab the bats, hoping this will be the inning they can break through. Pittsburgh has six hits, but nothing to show for it. As you see, Lincecum only giving up three hits so far. So in the eighth inning, a 1-2 count. Hicks just trying to hang on. As a matter of fact, he's going to do better. He's going to hit this to the gap over Hamilton's head, and he's going to have to field that off the wall. It is a double for Aaron Hicks. This is a big opportunity here now. Runner standing on second with nobody out. Socha knows that he's got an issue here. He's going to go get Weaver. And so despite a great start, he has no chance of winning this ball game. His best outcome will be a no decision. And he is responsible for that runner at second, so he could get hung for a loss. So Mark Lowe will come out and try to mop this up and keep this a scoreless game. Let's see what he can do. So with a 1-0 count, thought about bunting here, but a swing away. Castro to third. Look at that! Really quick decision on the throw to go to third as soon as he threw it. Oh, that could have been dangerous had he pump faked and tagged him out, but he didn't. So he moves over to third, and now McCutcheon's got the squeeze on. If you've been watching this series, you know I like the suicide squeeze. Pujols has a moment right there where he just forgets to do anything. Vapor lock, and everybody's safe. I don't know why he's not throwing to first in time, but I'm not going to go ask him as well. We'll just take the play. So McCutcheon comes through with an RBI on the suicide squeeze, and it's 1-0. That is a huge run in this ballgame. So now the question of the day, is it enough for Tim Lincecum to get this done? Changeup gets Clark swinging, and another strikeout. Lincecum, you see right here, 94 pitches, and only the three hits, eight strikeouts. Will he have enough gas to get this done? 2-2, two outs, and he gets another strikeout to get out of the inning. So he'll come into the ninth, right around the 100 pitch mark. This is a grounder to short. And Castro gets out number one. Once again, Mike Trout goes down quietly. You see Lincecum has really handled these bats of the Angels well. He's at 101 pitches now and two outs to go. Can he get through? 1-2 count. Coming with the low changeup, and Callaspo swings over it. Strike three. That is his 10th strikeout of the ballgame. And Lincecum just one out away. Of course it is Josh Hamilton. He can put the ball in the seat at any time. But he takes that slider for strike two. Hamilton not so sure. You see him shaking the head. Little shrug of the shoulders. Yeah. He's got the 1-2 count now. And he won't bite on the changeup outside. And we come back with... Oh! He drops the slider again. But this time does not get the call. I thought it was strike three. Oh, we don't want him on base with Pujols coming up. We don't want to give up a homer. 3-2 count. Two-seam fastball gets him. Strike three. 11th strikeout of the game. And it is a complete game shutout for Tim Lincecum. This is the reason we went out and got him. Don't tell me to sit him because of his ERA. It doesn't matter. Raise that Jolly Roger because we got a victory. And it's not only a victory, we got a shutout. So Tim Lincecum, yeah. What are you trying to do? Take him out of the lineup? I don't know what kind of advice that was. Obviously, they were going by the ERA saying he was trending bad. But come on, man. This is the reason I went out and got Tim Lincecum. And he proves it right here. Proves me right. And we've got the complete game shutout. So nice job there. As you see the line score right there. Just three hits. 11 strikeouts. Truly a gem there. Jared Weaver, my goodness. That is a tough luck loss. If I'm Weaver, I'm frustrated because he pitched just about as well as he could pitch. And with the big bats in that lineup, you expect more run support. Well, some run support at least. But Tim Lincecum really shuts him down and is rightfully so your player of the game with the complete game three hitter. As you see a couple of his highlight strikeouts here, he really was masterful of changing speeds and changing locations and just keeping these hitters off their comfort zone all game long. So we'll take a start like that from Timmy any day. So great to have him at the top of our rotation. And great to get the win in Anaheim. So the 1-0 victory behind us. And it is time to kind of do a reset here. See where we stand in the standings. Sim forward a little bit as we move closer and closer to the All-Star break. You see we're at the end of June and we've got some winning going on. Sweep Seattle in a two-game series. We swept LA before that. So, wow, things are looking nice here. Take two of three from Milwaukee. Now we got a date with first place in the East, Philadelphia. And you look, we sit just one game behind the Cubbies in the Central. Things are heating up here in July 2013. Come on back for more Pittsburgh Pirates franchise. We'll see you next time.